Good morning. I am Interim Provost Andy Rundquist, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the 2022 Commencement Ceremony at Hamline University, held here in the St. Paul RiverCentre. For those of you who don't know me, I'm also that weird person who plays the plastic trombone at some of the games at Hamline. You will note in your printed program that our land acknowledgement statement is supposed to be read by Sarah Jean Welch. She is unable to be here today because of the success of the Hamline women's lacrosse team. A thrilling overtime win last weekend put them into the first round of the NCAA Division III Women's Lacrosse Championship. They are competing in Chicago today, and of course we wish them luck. As we begin our time together today, I'd like to invite the director of the Hedgen Center and Associate Dean of Students, Carlos Seed, to give the land acknowledgement statement.
Good morning. You may be seated. Hamline University acknowledges that the land on which we gather, and we refer to it as Minnesota, is the traditional and unceded territory of the Dakota and the Ojibwe. Minnesota comes from the Dakota word, which means Minnesota, Makota, the land where the waters reflect the waters. We pay respect to the citizens of not only those tribes, but others as well, both past and present, and their continual relationship to their ancestral lands. Making this recognition expresses gratitude and appreciation to those whose territory we reside on and honors the traditions of the indigenous people who have been existing with and on the land from time immemorial. This long-standing history is significant as land acknowledgments do not exist in a past tense or historical context. Colonialism, appropriation, and genocide have a relevant, real-time reality. We need to build mindfulness regarding the source of our present land privilege, understanding the long-standing history from which it comes, and seek to reconcile our place within both. Hamline, as an institution and community, will hold itself accountable as an indigenous partner by working stridently to amplify, address, and counter the historical and contemporary injustices that continue to impact indigenous people individually, systemically, and structurally. Please welcome our practice.
Thank you, Carlos. I now invite University Chaplain Kelly Figueroa Ray to come to the podium to give the invitation.
Please stand. It is so good to gather today, both in person and online, to celebrate and give thanks for our 2022 Hamline graduates. As we begin this time of recognition together, let us all pause for a moment to reflect on the joy of this momentous occasion, to reflect on everything that has gone into getting us to this point. And for those of you who desire, would you please join me in a spirit of prayer? Source of all beginnings, we come before you today in gratitude and seek your blessing on all gathered here and online. For those graduating, today's ceremony marks the end of their student journeys and sets in motion their beginning as Hamline alumni, following in the footsteps of Hamline and Minnesota's first college graduates in 1859, Elizabeth and Emily Soren. Source of all beginnings, bless this transition and those who have walked it before us and with us. Commencement means a start. A start in which we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, a start for which these graduates are equipped. These graduates face challenges beyond comprehension for these past 2 years and preserved through extreme difficulties and loss. Source of all beginnings, help us to hold our grief and joy as we acknowledge the difficulty and blessing of the path we have walked. Help each of us here savor this day of joy and celebration. We give thanks for each and every one of these graduates. Let each one know that this moment of recognition is well deserved. Let each one know that they are enough. Let each one know they deserve to be here and to be showered with all the honor and grace that this beginning signifies. Amen. May we see them.
Thank you, Catherine Kelly. I'd like to take a moment to recognize our members of the Board of Trustees. Trustees, will you please stand? Thank you for being here. Thank you. Now, a few numbers about the class of 2022. More than half have earned Latin honors. 40% of the class of 2022 is first generation. 29% are students of color, one of the most diverse classes we've had in years. There are also several groups of graduates I'd like to recognize. First are the students whose academic achievements have been exceptional. If you are graduating with Latin honors, departmental honors, have participated in the University Honors Program, or were inducted into Phi Beta Kappa, or another National Honor Society, would you please stand now and be recognized? Thank you. You may be seated. Hamline has a long tradition of legacy families. In our ceremony today, those students wearing a burgundy and gray cord have a parent, grandparent, spouse, sibling, or children who have also graduated from Hamline. With these legacy graduates and their families, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. At Hamline, we are firmly committed to supporting those who are the first in their family to complete college. If you are a first-generation student graduating today, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Please be seated. We would like to recognize the graduates who are also veterans. Please stand and be recognized, not only for your achievement today, but for your service to our country. Thank you. Please be seated. But certainly not least, please stand if you are a graduate today. Thank you. You may be seated. Now I would like to ask Brenda Edmondson Heim, class of 1977, chair of our Board of Trustees, to bring greetings on their behalf.
Good morning. I am pleased to be here in my official role of chair of the Board of Trustees of Hamline University. Welcome to this commencement ceremony celebrating the class of 2022. You have come to this day after a lot of hard work, long hours of study, perhaps a job or two, and filling your time with other activities. As an athlete, maybe a musician, an artist, in public service, and I hope with some time and a helping of fun, camaraderie, whatever it was that drew you to Hamline, I hope that as you leave, you have found time to celebrate. You have made friends, and it hasn't been easy with the pandemic, but you have persevered. You adapted. You made it through to this day with support from your peers, your faculty, your friends, and your families. Getting to graduation is a shared journey. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Hamline Universities, I want to congratulate you for being here today. I hope that you will take your skills, get your Hamline experience out into the world and make an impact. Thank you for the part you will play in our future. I hope you take the Hamline skills of service, compassion, leadership, and scholarship as your guiding principles. We are grateful for all that you have given us while you are here, and we are now excited to share in your accomplishments. Thank you, and best of luck as you leave the Hamline community. Please come back and join with us. Congratulations.
LaKaya Ziegler, please join us on the stage. Good morning, everyone. I'm Patty Kirsten, the Dean of Students. And now we will be recognizing our Wesley Award recipient. The Wesley Award Leadership and Service Awards were established by the Board of Trustees to recognize those students whose leadership, service to others, and at the Hamline University best exemplifies the spirit of the Methodist founder, John Wesley, to do all of the good that you can. These are the university's most prestigious awards, which is why we award to the students during commencement. And we've asked former recipients to wear the medallions at commencements in the future. Please turn to page 27 and 28 in your program to read more about each of our student recipients this year. Presenting the award medallions is Brenda Heim, the chair of our Board of Trustees. One of our 2022 recipients is Kaya Ziegler, who is graduating with a degree in English with a philosophy and minoring in business practice and Mandarin training. Kaya received her award last year and was also the student government president. Our other recipients will be recognized at the next ceremony at 1 o'clock is Rena Myers, who is graduating with honorary degrees and a major in history, political science, and public health. Again, please join me in congratulating our 2022 John Wesley Award recipient. Thank you.
Today I have the privilege of honoring a man who has accomplished much in his life of public service. Mark Dayton, would you please step forward? Our first honorary degree recipient has a long history of support for education and the undoubted benefit it provides to us all. A native-born Minnesotan raised in Long Lake, he was true to state's passion for hockey, spending a lot of time on the ice working on his goaltending skills. He received his BA from Yale University, where he was a psychology major and played varsity hockey. After graduation, he immediately dove into serving the community. One of his first jobs was in a school on New York's Lower East Side. That was followed by getting involved in a Boston social service agency, working with at-risk youth. However, he heard the clarion call to be a public servant, and in 1975, he joined the staff of the late Senator Walter Mondale. In 1976, he worked for the Carter Mondale campaign and did every job that was needed to help. After the successful campaign was over, it was time to come back home. Mark Dayton, assisting then Governor Rudy Perkins as the head of Minnesota Department of Economic Development. His journey as a public servant focused more and more on small businesses and trying to elevate their success. Mark Dayton took time away from government work to work in the investment business, but the strong pull of service pulled him back into the political arena. He was the taxpayer's watchdog, as he describes it, for the 4 years he was a state auditor. Significantly, about 25 years after he served on Vice President Mondale's Senate campaign, Mark Dayton was himself elected as a U.S. Senator from Minnesota, a proud moment indeed. As Senator, he was a relentless champion and advocate for special education and education in general. This continued when he left the Senate to become the 40th governor of the state of Minnesota, serving two terms. During his time in office, he championed education, same-sex marriage, and social justice among his numerous other crusades for the public good. John Wesley's words about doing all the good you can, which we know so well here at Hamline, have truly been put into action during a lifetime of service. I am proud to introduce the first honorary degree recipient for 2022, the Honorable Mark Dayton. Therefore, by the powers vested in me by the Hamline University Board of Trustees, I present to you, Mark Dayton, the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights, privileges, and honors thereunto appertaining on this 14th day of May, 2022.
Well, if I don't choke, I'll finish my remarks. Thank you, President Miller and Chair Hyman, for those awards and these gracious remarks. I'm very, very grateful to receive this honorary degree from this distinguished institution, which was recently ranked as our state's best regional university by both U.S. News and World Report and the Washington Monthly. So all of you who are receiving your degrees today deserve to be very proud of your achievements. And unlike my honorary degree, you had to work long and hard to earn yours. I hope your families and friends also take pride in your successes. Jacqueline Kennedy once said she thought that if you failed to raise your children well, it didn't matter what you accomplished with the rest of your life. So parents, my congratulations to you as well, to your sons and daughters. It's been 53 years since I received my BA degree in 1969. Back then, I was still hopeful that my generation would surpass even the preceding greatest generation for that distinction. I was optimistic that we would provide enlightened leadership for our nation and our world, creating social, racial, and economic equity, environmental sanity, and world peace. Now, half a century later, I must face the hard reality of my generation's failures. Yes, we have made some impressive improvements in the human condition, but our country and world remain ravaged by awful injustices, planetary degradation, and devastation caused by dangerous diseases and dictators. I'm distraught by what we are leaving to our children, our grandchildren, and the generations that follow them, including our failure to fund your generation's college education, which has forced many of you and your families into deep financial debt. When I was a United States Senator, I told college students I thought it was wrong for my generation to tell you how important your college education was, how greatly it would benefit you and our country, but we weren't going to help you pay for it. Yet we expected you then to work hard to fund our Social Security and Medicare so we could retire in appropriate comfort. I said that your generation should tell my generation to go get ourselves a loan. Well, now that I'm on Social Security, that idea doesn't have quite the same appeal. But I do apologize sincerely to you, as I have to my children and grandchildren, for the serious difficulties you will inherit, which is why the excellent education you have received here at Hamline is so vitally important. It has provided you with a strong foundation from which you can create successful and fulfilling lives even in these difficult times. In closing, let me share with you the best advice I ever received. After I lost my first statewide campaign in 1982, Senator Ted Kennedy, who had befriended me, took me aside and said, quote, "Mark, perseverance is the prerequisite for success in politics. It doesn't guarantee success, but it is the prerequisite for success." I think that's true for most of the important things in life. You will inevitably encounter hardships, setbacks, and even defeats. It would be easy to call it quits. Too easy. Winston Churchill said, "When you're going through hell, keep on going." That's the key. Keep on trudging through adversity and go beyond. Defeat is only permanent if you give up. With your talents and with the outstanding educations you've received here at Hamline, if you persevere, I guarantee you will succeed. And you will accomplish even more than you dream about now. So celebrate today, then relax a little about your future and enjoy the journey. It's been said that getting there isn't half the fun, it's all the fun. So go have some fun. Thank you.
Cow, will you please come forward? As you'll see in the program on page 6, Yi was chosen in a competition to be the class speaker. She has added much to our community through her academic talent and leadership. Please welcome her.
Good morning, everyone. How is everyone? Hello. There you go. Hi, everyone. My name is Yi Tao with pronouns of she, hers. and I'm honored to be speaking at commencement for the class of 2022. I would like to express my gratitude to faculty, staff, alumni, friends, and family for your presence and celebrating a big chapter in our lives. Now, Hamline, our Hamline, a history of firsts and commitment to educate all, a career ready and building a better society through education. We have embodied leadership, scholarship, and service with a diverse community we have built here. During our first year orientation, we sat next to our some classmates, doing countless hours of icebreakers that our NSM made us do. We made pterodactyl sounds, and we walked in fear by how close these campus squirrels would run next to us. During orientation, we also learned about consent. We did an exercise asking the person next to us, "Hey, can I touch your shoulder?" And as silly and as awkward the exercise may have been, it plays an important role in how we treat others in respect to what their boundaries are. Today, which marks our last day, I would like to lead and have us continue practicing what we've learned from our first couple days as a Hamline undergraduate student by adding to. Please participate if you are able to. Finding a person beside you, ask, "Hey, can I touch your shoulder?" If they allow, touch the shoulders. If they are not comfortable with it, respect their decisions and exchange eyes behind each other's masks and then tell them, "I am proud of you." To some, this is a reminder. And for those who came from tough love like me, it means more than just words. So I thank everyone for participating in this segment on my speech. As we hold many identities, I stand here today as a child of immigrant parents and a first-generation Hmong woman college graduate. This very day is special to me, not only because we're graduating and I'm making my family proud, but because we are graduating on Hmong American Day. Forty-seven years ago today, General Vang Pao fled from Laos to Minnesota, making Minnesota the Hmong people's new home. Mark Dayton, who is here with us today, signed in 2013 for May 14th, as a day to honor, recognize, and celebrate the history, culture, and contributions of the Hmong Americans in Minnesota. Thank you to Mr. Dayton for your diligent work. As we sit here today, graduates, my colleagues, waiting for our names to be called and walking across the stage, we reflect on the sacrifices and changes we have made to be receiving this degree. College can be a very exciting part of our life, but it can also be the loneliest experience we've ever encountered. Through it all, we began to find different versions of ourselves through the love we have been given. Growing up in a small cramped house that my parents left Atta and Zhejiang worked hard in their blue-collar jobs, and together with my five siblings, Lang, Po, Shuo, Ho, Mimi, and I don't know why our names run through, we call it a home. The place that we call home, our love language is food. Whenever my mom called me, the first thing she would ask me was not, how was your day? But rather, meantime, what about the mall? My daughter, have you eaten yet? For my dad, my siblings and I would comment on how good an orange would be. And without any word exchanges, the next day, we'd see a whole bag of oranges on the kitchen table. This was their way of saying, I care and I love you. On behalf of all of us graduating today, there will be artists, psychologists, lawyers, educators, or whichever future you deem for yourself, we will be taking the lead. I hope to see all of us succeed in whichever path you take. To end off, I would like to say, like how we walk past each other on Hamline's beautiful campus, how we converse in short conversations while on the way to our next class, to having deep conversations in the quiet places around Hamline, I hope it will not be the last for us all. I hope we continue to cross paths outside of Hamline University and say to one another, I am proud of you. Thank you to my dad, Chow and John's family, Suda Ishida, Leticia Baspar, Jane Kent, Hmong Student Association, and the generations before me for giving me the courage and motivation to speak for today. I am incredibly honored to be part of Class of 2022 here at Hamline University. Congratulations to us all, and thank you.
The Honorable Dayton for their remarks. They've got us going in the right direction. And I say good morning to all of you. Graduates, I ask you to stand and applaud your professors. I now ask you to look behind you and applaud those who help make it possible for you to be here today. This is a day of celebration of and with you, our 2022 graduates. On behalf of the Hamline community, I congratulate you on the completion of your degree. As I look out among you, I see the future of this state, this nation, this world. I see among you future politicians, scientists, educators, professors, nonprofit management leaders, bankers, CEOs, doctors, lawyers, accountants, financial officers, university presidents, musicians, criminal artists, criminal justice advocates, leaders in every sector imaginable. I see hope for the future. I see the greatness that is possible for this nation, this world within each of you. I see a rainbow of people with strong hearts,
and incredible intellect. While I know you've learned much during your time in Hamline, I hope there's one lesson that you will keep front and center as you live your life, as you do the work you want and need to do. The lesson I hope you have learned is that we are better, stronger, more effective when we work together, when we walk together. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. in his I Have a Dream speech said, and I quote, "We cannot walk alone. And as we walk, we must pledge that we shall always march ahead. We cannot turn back." Let me repeat. We cannot turn back. Although Dr. King was referring to race relations and economic and civil rights in America, his words are appropriate to and can be applied to a more modern day context. So I say to you, you cannot turn back. The world I grew up in during my younger years is not the world I want for each of you. I want you to be free to continue to be whomever you choose to be, to live whatever life is best for you and those you love, to respect and appreciate differences in all its many permutations, to embrace each other as equals, regardless of gender, race, sexuality, or class, to see your body, your mind, your space as belonging to you, not someone else. In other words, I want you to be socially excellent. As Lucia Clifton, a learned and astute American poet, once said, and I quote, "In the bigger scheme of things, the universe is not asking us to be something, to do something. It is asking us to be something. And that's a whole different thing. We want and need you to be something. Not just in terms of the identity you carve out due to your career or job. Not just the family you hold closer and dearer than life itself, but to the nation, the world. We want you to be that person who's not afraid to give truth to power, to stand up for the rights of all and against oppressive thinking and behavior, behavior that could return us to turbulent times. Both times were marked by slavery and various inequalities, like economic and social inequality, gender inequality, marriage inequality, all steeped in notions of inferiority based on physical differences. While I do not believe we will go back to embracing all the behaviors, policies, and practices of the past, I do believe that if we do not march forward, if we cannot envision the world we need and want, we'll be doomed to relive the actions of our past. This is where you, our 2022 graduates, come into play. Your view of the world is astonishing. Your ability to reach across aisles and form relationships is a thing to behold. Your brain power never ceases to amaze us. And your sense of care and justice will free us all. You give us, you give me hope. In 2018, you show the world who you are by voting in record numbers and leading Hamline to be designated as the top university in the country for the percentage of students who vote. In 2020, you continue the trend. We remain among the top voters in the nation. You show what it means to be a Hamline Piper. You continue to do all you can to address food insecurity, to break down the barriers of inequality, to work with your peers to make the world a better place. I am humbled by your passion, your commitment, and your call to action. You, Hamline Pipers, are the dream keepers, the hope makers. You've chosen to look and march forward, to focus on hope, to not only dream about a better world, but to work towards making it so. It is your hope that we will lead this nation into the future, a future of possibilities. Hamline is a better, stronger institution because of you. We here at Hamline University hope we've helped you to continue to look forward to envision the world you need and want, and then make it so. We hope we've given you the tools necessary to be effective thinkers, problem solvers, decision makers, and change makers. More importantly, we hope we help you understand and appreciate what it means to be a good citizen, to be deliberative, collaborative, and relational. We hope you help you learn how to talk to and listen to others, to be deliberative with those whose views might not be the same as yours. We hope we've taught you to be collaborative, to work with others, and reflect on the work done as part of a team. We hope we've taught you how to learn self, how to love self, how to love others. We hope we've strengthened your understanding of the phrase life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It is our hope that you will realize the word a more perfect union. We need you to do that. And I hope, on behalf of your professors and the staff here at Hamline University, we've educated you to understand what it means to uphold and be part of a democracy. To uphold and be part of a democracy. I can't tell you how important that is to me, as someone who grew up in the early years in segregation. When I say I don't want us to return to that time, I don't want us to return to that time. I don't want us to return to a time when my rights didn't exist because of what I look like. You have the power to make sure this never happens again. And we are relying on you to do so. On January 6th, our democracy was threatened. We've seen attempts to roll back voting rights for college students, for others. We've seen attempts to roll back those rights that many of us thought we had forever. Many of those rights that allowed me and so many others to live my life with balance, that I could work, and I could be a mom, and I could be so many other things, I could be a member of society. I want you to be able to choose what you do and how you do it. Today is a new beginning for all of you, a time to march forward with hope for your future and hope for the nation and the world. You leave the camera with us, nice and huge, wrote in this poem to you, with our hopes and dreams for you. You leave Hamline, but I hope you never forget Hamline. The classes you took, the professors you had, the lessons you learned about democracy. You see, I keep coming back to that word because I can't let it go. I have to come back to it. You've had many friends, but along the way, I hope you had fun. Did you? Did you have fun? Yes. I watched so many of you on the field, on the court, in the pool, wherever you were, in Sunday Hall, in Hamline Church, perform and uphold who we are as an institution. You represented us well. As Maya Angelou stated, and I have no doubt that these words are true, I've learned that people will forget what you said. That's true. You forget what I said today, but that's okay. But one thing you will never forget is how people made you feel. How we at Hamline made you feel. How your colleagues, your peers made you feel. How your professors made you feel. How your family made you feel. It was our intent here at Hamline University to give you a sense of belonging, to let you know that you are part of this community in every single way.
So we're proud of each and every last one of you, and I congratulate you for a job well done. I leave you with the words of James Baldwin. The hope of the world lies in what one demands, not of others, but of oneself. Now I say to each of you, go out and discharge the offices of life with usefulness and purpose. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Arts, and Bachelor of Science please rise? President Miller, the faculty has recommended these students for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, and Bachelor of Science, and the recommendation has been approved. It is my pleasure to present them to you and ask that you confer upon them their degree.
Good morning. Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Business Administration please stand? President Miller? The faculty has recommended these students for the degree of Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Business Administration, and the recommendation has been approved. It is my pleasure to present them to you and ask that you confer upon them their degrees. First row of graduates, would you please come forward? The rest of you may be seated.
Abdi Sattar Ali, Bachelor of Arts. Crystal Simon, Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Arsenault, Bachelor of Science, Magna Cum Laude. Anita Athicon, Bachelor of Arts. Bridget Eileen Benson, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Sagal Blomgren, Bachelor of Arts.
Haley Bobert. Alexis Anne-Marie Borgensen, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Eddie Cassidy Britsky, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude.
Aiden Foster Peck Chapman, Bachelor of Science, University Honors, Summa Cum Laude. Raven Christensen, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Sam Tanner Edwin Cole, Bachelor of Arts. William Condit, Bachelor of Business Administration. Isaiah Danielson, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Reina Davila Day, Bachelor of Business Administration. Quinn Doan, Bachelor of Business Administration. Kylie Ann Donfris, Bachelor of Arts. McKenna Emery, Bachelor of Business Administration. Bailey Elise Finley, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Christopher Antonio Fuente, Bachelor of Arts.
Brenda Garcia Rodriguez, Bachelor of Arts. Chloe Lauren Gruy, Bachelor of Arts. Taylor Ann Haney, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Erin Marie Zinke, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Carlton Hoagland, Bachelor of Arts. Gabriel Hopke, Bachelor of Arts. McKenna Ray Punkinen, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Taylor Hopkins, Bachelor of Science, Summa Cum Laude. Emily Kaufman, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude.
Michael Foran, Bachelor of Business Administration. Olivia Posky, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Brody Kuchera, Bachelor of Business Administration, Cum Laude. Ashwin Kumar Kufa, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Zoe Lance, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Jordan Kenneth Lawson, Bachelor of Science. Olivia Rose Lee, Bachelor of Fine Arts, University Honors, Summa Cum Laude. Matt Leventhal, Bachelor of Arts. Allison McFarland, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Emma Manalis, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Jesse Mickelson, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Charles Murphy, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Jenna Pauline Nelson, Bachelor of Arts. Anna Jolie O'Connor, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Matthew J. Peters, Bachelor of Arts. Amaya Pettis, Bachelor of Business Administration.
Sarah Elizabeth Pearson, Bachelor of Science. Parker Lauren Reindel, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Josephine Renee Sanchez, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Jacqueline Joy Stoviak, Bachelor of Business Administration. Jonah William Smallfield, Bachelor of Arts. Thomas Tusang Tao, Bachelor of Arts. Tristan Tusang Tao, Bachelor of Science. Arts. Heidi Terrace, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Allison Kim Thomas, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Eric Torres Sanchez, Bachelor of Arts.
Tenzin Sundu, Bachelor of Business Administration. Jack G. Van Catter, Bachelor of Business Administration. Jamie Vasquez Germano, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Catherine Mary Jane Viles, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Cole Anthony Wagner, Bachelor of Business Administration, cum laude. John Weeple, Bachelor of Arts. Anza Nayila Williams, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Jillian Wortman, Bachelor of Arts, University Honors, magna cum laude. Gabriela Yanez, Bachelor of Business Administration.
Hannah Maisie Pickering, Bachelor of Arts. Amanda Eleanor Libby, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Emma Rose Harrington, Bachelor of Arts, University Honors, summa cum laude. Michaela Booking, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Lauren Green, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Hannah Amira Umadi, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Natalia Fox, Bachelor of Arts. Kat Grace Hanks, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Catherine Daisy, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Erin Elizabeth Tadish, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Sydney Marie Larson, Bachelor of Science, cum laude. Lauren Olivia Jane Sotnick, Bachelor of Arts. Katie Minervino, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Noah Lee Vu, Bachelor of Arts.
Andrew Nicholas Hatling, Bachelor of Business Administration, Summa Cum Laude. Patrick Quinn Kelly, Bachelor of Science, Magna Cum Laude. Jillian Suzanne Anderson, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Logan Christopher Tolleson, Bachelor of Business Administration, Cum Laude. Braden Charles Snyder, Bachelor of Business Administration, Magna Cum Laude. Hayden Brandt Green, Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Business Administration, Double Degree, Magna Cum Laude. Avery Hammond Nelson, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Teague Williams Bogenholm, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Ryan Roger Kahn, Bachelor of Business Administration. Summer Vane, Bachelor of Arts. Taylor Louise Crassus, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. MJ Luna, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Hannah Dahl, Bachelor of Arts. Jacob Antonio Aloy, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude with Distinction in History. Summer Marie Carlton, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude.
Cass Coles, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. William Deary, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Donald A. Burtman, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Jesse Massima Luviano, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Andrea Rose Lindner, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Kaya Christine Ziegler, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Yi Tao, Bachelor of Arts. Yi Tao, Bachelor of Arts. Lu Her, Bachelor of Science, University Honors, Summa Cum Laude. Logan Michael Ballas, Bachelor of Science, Summa Cum Laude. Madeline Kathleen Marston, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Adrian Paul Cacalici, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Rudy Antonio Barron, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Jacqueline Madison Mulcahy, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Bachelor J. Deutsch, Bachelor of Arts. Evelyn Denise Humphrey, Bachelor of Arts, Magna Cum Laude. Callie Mae Weisenbach, Bachelor of Science, Cum Laude. Hoosier Zong, Bachelor of Science. Maika Zhang Yang, Bachelor of Science, University Honors, Magna Cum Laude. Maggie McLean Nesset, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. A.J. Moore, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Cum Laude. Daniel John Frederick, Bachelor of Arts. Spencer DeLambo, Bachelor of Arts, Summa Cum Laude. Dane Dagerstrom Hamline, Bachelor of Science. Tri Lee, Bachelor of Business Administration. Paul Tripney, Bachelor of Arts. Troy Burgeon, Bachelor of Arts.
Before we end, I want to remind you of the words of John Wesley. We say these words to each other in the beginning and when you leave. And it's my pleasure to say them to you on this, your graduation day. These are the words by John Wesley. Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as ever you can. One page too far. I was just told I went one page too far. I saw Gunderson and Costa-Hova. That's them. All right, now I'm going to go back since all of you are back in your seats. Will the candidates in the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Business Administration, please rise? Upon the recommendation of the faculty, with the approval of the trustees of the Hamline University of Minnesota, and with the authority vested in me as president by the trustees, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Business Administration, for all the rights, duties, and privileges thereunto appertaining. Graduates, you may move your tassels. Whichever side you need to move it to.
student. Congratulations to each and every last one of you. We are so very, very proud of you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Heather Hammond, and I'm a 2014 graduate of Hamline University. I currently serve on Hamline's Board of Directors, and on behalf of all of my fellow members, I want to welcome you, our new graduates, to the Hamline Alumni Association. Congratulations. Each of you have earned every moment of celebration for this academic accomplishment. Today's milestones represent countless successes, perhaps a few failures or setbacks, but without a doubt, breakthroughs. We commend you for all of your hard work and perseverance. You're now part of a community that exists to support fellow alumni and future graduates who will be sitting in these same chairs in the coming years. We know you will add greatly to the Hamline Alumni Network as you leave here today and take your leadership roles in the world. Please stay in touch and call on each other and the Alumni Association to help you on your journey, because once we're a Piper, we're always a Piper. Again, on behalf of the entire alumni community, congratulations. We are so excited and proud to have you join the ranks of Hamline alum.
Will the audience please stand and remove your hats for the benediction? The platform party can remain seated. To our guests, please stay in your places until the reception is completed and the faculty has exited. Chaplain Kelly, if you're already, would you please give the benediction?
As our ceremony comes to an end, all things are being made new. Bless Hamline faculty, staff, and administration as they savor the excitement of this day and witness the fruits of their labor, passion, and care. Bless all the family members and friends and support systems that have accompanied these graduates and helped them make it here today. Bless the long line of Hamline alumni and these new alumni as they join their ranks and take what they have learned to do all the good as compassionate change makers in pursuit of a better world for all.